Hey, it's Olga here from OlgaDegtyareva.com and Productivity for Scientists. This is where you overcome overwhelm, become more productive, get in charge of your day while feeling happy in your life. And the topic of today's video is your calendar and how you use it. And I want to ask you this question: do you use your calendar only for external appointments? This is what I've discovered in a conversation, a private conversation with one of my clients, when we were talking about scheduling things into her calendar, and she said that she only uses it for external appointments. And this is maybe something that you are doing right now as well. And today I want to show you and explain to you how you can expand the use of your calendar and actually also schedule the internal appointments with yourself, things that you want to do with yourself, by yourself, for yourself, and it doesn't involve any external things. You could still schedule them in your calendar, and I want to explain to you how powerful it can be for your productivity. So right now you might be using your calendar only for external appointments, such as the meetings at the university, your teaching, maybe their meeting with your supervisor, or the head of the group. If you have a doctor appointment, you would put it in there. So anything external, or if you have a family and you have kids, you sometimes would put their appointments in there as well to make sure that you bring them there, or make sure that they've online on Zoom on time there, right? So these are the external appointments, and most of us would use our calendars for that, right? So today I want to show you how you can use a calendar for scheduling the internal appointments with yourself. What does it mean? Well, in my coaching, when you would start with to work with me, the first thing we do, we create like a sessions writing that we get clear on the time and date for your writing sessions, and that would be usually their appointments with yourself when you sit down and you put everything aside and you open them, the file for your paper or for your thesis. And this is especially needed if it's constantly shifted to the back burner, right? If you want to do it every day or every week, but it never gets done. So it's very, very important to create a specific time of a specific day when you are going to sit down and do it. And this is what we do with my clients. And then I invite them to schedule it into their calendar, actually highlight that section. You know, if you're using Google Calendar, I use a paper calendar, so I would write there from like 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock in the morning. That would be my focus time, that would be my writing time. You know, if you're working in a particular chapter for a book or a thesis, you would write there thesis chapter such and such, or paper such and such. So it's a very specific appointment with yourself for your writing. Use your calendar to actually schedule it. And why is it important? Well, it's in your sight, it's on your mind, you're less likely to forget it, you're more likely to take it seriously. And then you can actually indicate if you have attended this appointment, and then analyze it. You know, if you are good with attending it, or if you're constantly skipping it, then you know you can analyze it. This is what we do in my coaching calls. We can analyze it. You know, why is it happening that you always miss it? How you can make it more attendable, okay? And also, you could do it for other things in your life, such as physical exercise or that special time with your friends or family. You can actually schedule it in your calendar, for example, when are you going to do your physical exercise? I'm recording this video in the second wave of the coronavirus, and there are many lockdowns around the world, second lockdown, so we are again working from home, exercising from home, or maybe some of the classes are open in your area, so put them in your calendar. Again, it's an appointment with yourself, it's an internal appointment. Put it in your calendar, and again, it's more likely to be on your mind, in your sight, reminding you. It's more commitment, and then you can again, you can indicate if you have done it or not. You can count how many times you've done it, and then you can increase your productivity because of that. Okay, I hope that a strategy is as good as resonating with you. It could really increase your productivity. And this is all for today. Post a comment if it resonated or if you have any questions. And if you're not yet receiving these videos into your inbox, go to my website. It's olgadegtyareva.com. At the top, there are free resources that you can sign up, free productivity resources, and you will also receive these videos into your inbox. Okay, this is all for today. Bye for now.